A cop has now been fired for trying to kill a child inside of a vehicle. I'm going to highlight an element of this story that many people have not caught yet. Let me first go to the video.
I got a vehicle over here that fled from me the other day. It's in the parking lot. License plate. Get out of the car.
What? Shots fired.
Earlier, he's gonna return on it right now.
Shots fired.
Rashad fired on 3161, 11700 Blanco Road, code 320.
Put up the picture of this cop. This cop has now been fired. This cop is now under criminal investigation. This cop needs to be arrested. His name is Officer James Brennand. Let me first explain this. Keep his picture up before we go into more detail of this story. When he called in to dispatch, he said the car had fled from him some time ago, which means there's some history between him and this kid. To me, it looked as if the kid knew what was about to happen. That's what it looked like to me. There's something there. There is more to this story. The San Antonio Police Department on Wednesday fired a police officer who shot a teenager outside a McDonald's restaurant less than a week ago. This cop, James Brennand, had been placed under administrative duty following the shooting on Sunday outside of the fast food restaurant. According to SAPD, Officer Brennand was fired for violating departmental tactics and procedures. You don't say. James Brennan was a probationary officer who served on the force for 7 months. SAPD said officers are on probation for 1 year after graduating from the police academy according to their own policy. But remember, as I have said, culture eats policy alive 7 days a week. So they may have a policy, but they also have a culture. Now, I guarantee you, he would have gotten away with this if there was no video footage of what actually happened. According to the SAPD report, Officer Brennan responded to a call for a disturbance at 10:45 p.m. and attempted to gather information from witnesses when he noticed a vehicle that had, according to him, evaded him the day before as he attempted a traffic stop because the registered license plate did not match the vehicle. That is a low level fine. You do not get arrested for having a tag that doesn't match your vehicle. You don't even go to jail for that. You pay a fine. There's more. The report said the prior incident was not related to the disturbance. The prior incident was not related to the disturbance at the restaurant. So let me get this right. You're so much of super cop that you give a damn about somebody and their license tag that happened a day or two before. I mean, that's what you're on the force to do. And when that person is afraid of you, you decide to simply indiscriminately shoot into their vehicle, knowing good and damn well this is a child you're dealing with. You get fired. You should have been arrested. You violate your own standards, violate your own protocol, violate the policies of your department, but you're still free. Erik Cantu, 17 years of age, okay? Suffered multiple gunshot wounds and was taken to University Hospital. The report stated that Officer Brennan performed CPR on Cantu before emergency medical technicians arrived. Cantu's a female passenger who was young also, could have died also, was not injured. Cantu was charged by proxy with evading detention in a vehicle and assault on an officer. The Bexar County DA, the Civil Rights Division, will now review the evidence submitted by the San Antonio Police Department. What does that tell you? That tells you that evidence has been submitted to the DA's office. The police typically do not submit evidence unless they believe a crime took place. Now, they still don't get a hero cookie here because they should have locked his ass up themselves. Okay? That's what should have happened. They decided to play politics with it and transfer it over. Okay? In the shooting of Erik Cantu by now former police officer, by that former police officer, once the SAPD investigation is complete, the DA's office will also review all evidence related to the charges against the 17-year-old once we have received it. The DA's office can make no comment on whether charges may be pursued against either individual until all evidence has been reviewed. Bexar County DA Joe Gonzalez said in a statement, let's put up a picture of Joe. Okay? I'm gonna say this, Mr. DA, you have an opportunity here to clearly show that you're for the people that put you in that position of power, that you do not bend over for cops who are corrupt in your community. You know what he did was criminal. You know those children could be dead right now over a freaking tag. Do the right thing, Mr. DA. Hold a press conference, make an example out of those cops just like you would have if this happened to be a member of the Crips or Piru Blood or Gangsta Disciple. Because they wear a badge does not mean they are not in the gang. Mr. Mayor, thoughts on this?
Listen, this is extremely disturbing for so many reasons. And I appreciate how you open up this segment and tell the truth. So many people, so many shows on so many networks that I've been on would have danced around the fact that their cops tried to kill those kids in that car. He shot 4 rapid shots with the door being halfway open to half closed, and then 3 more. After he called in shots fired, not saying that he had shot fired, putting people on the alarm on the other end of that dispatch, thinking that cops is taking fire. Secondly, think about the ego, this unattached ego in this officer. You were responding to a disturbance at a restaurant. What kind of disturbance? He didn't go in there to investigate what was going on at that restaurant. This car was not associated with that. But his ego of someone fleeing and getting away from him a few days ago about, like you said, a crime that is not even punishable by detention, which also makes me look at the charges against this kid evading detention when that's not an outcome that they were invading, right?
That's right.
So I mean we have to look at that, but then we also think about this cop left people that had already called you for disturbance. You left that unattended to. The discrepancies in this is unbelievable, and I find it so ironic that the police department and the correctional justice system and criminal justice system in general spend so much money on making sure that we can track and monitor people coming home from prisons and people that are on probation, but we don't have the same systems to track and monitor police officers who are on probation. You put this person out there with less than a year worth of training to drive around with a car that is equipped to go faster than normal cars, with a gun that can do deadly force, as we just saw, and nobody to watch over him. I think it's criminal that the San Antonio Police Department have a probationary officer out there without a supervising officer.
Come on, brother. I have never seen a probationary officer have that kind of tactical command over a scene. Never. Okay? And there's a reason why.